People have been getting tattooed for generations. A lot of times, people viewed that as a form of rebellion. I got my first tattoo at the age of 14, and I guess you could say I've been rebelling ever since. But it's what you do with that rebellion that really matters.
There's Kofi Kingston, highlight reel.
Maybe with just the right amount of rebellion, you can even learn to fly.
It's all about the new day, people. It's all about the new day.
These are the stories behind the art. This is WWE Superstar Inc. And this chapter is Kofi Kingston.
So we've managed to find an arcade inside a building. I think like all the arenas should have this.
This is amazing. It's actually one of my favorite buildings to come to because like the day goes by so fast. Like you see guys in here. We actually had to lock the door. Sitting in here, you know, playing ping pong all day. It's like, you know, middle school, elementary school all over again.
Yeah, we kicked everyone out. I'm waiting for the door to just bust open and have to reshoot the whole thing.
Yeah.
I miss arcades, man. I haven't been in an arcade forever.
I have an arcade at home. It has like 250 games in it. You know what I'm saying? Like my son is going to be 2. I took him up probably like 3 or 4 months ago to try and like see if he would gravitate towards it. So I like turned it on and everything, and he just kind of like looks at it and goes and like goes to the drums.
It's like prehistoric right, now. Yeah.
Turn it off, and I'm like, you know, we'll try it again in 6 months. You know what I'm saying?
Zoom in on these eyes.
So what was Kofi Kingston like in high school? What were you into?
I was in the video games, sports. Honestly, I kept a lot to myself.
Kind of a family man, almost a mother's boy, if you will.
I never got into like a lot of trouble, you know what I'm saying? And the trouble that I would have got into, like I never got caught, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, just very, very laid back.
So what brought you to the tattoo?
Well, it was one of those things where I had always wanted to get one. Even I have a picture of myself at like a fair. I used to live in New Orleans, so they drew like a pelican on me, and I'm like showing off with my sleeves rolled up, drinking a soda. Just, you know, so I've always like wanted a tattoo on my arm, and my parents would never let me get one. This tattoo, you know, we had our senior prom or whatever, and the day afterwards, we spent all day like on the beach and whatnot. I think the plan was for all of us to go and get tattoos, and I was the only one that did. You know, it was, to me, just me kind of becoming a man and doing whatever I wanted to do.
But obviously you didn't stop there, you got some more.
I got tattoos down my spine. They're called Adinkra symbols. As everyone knows, I'm from Ghana. These symbols are particular to the Ashanti tribe, which is, you know, where my heritage comes from. So all the tattoos that you see going down my spine have significant meaning. They represent the way that I try to live my life. One on the top is actually their war horns. And basically what they symbolize is vigilance and wariness. You always have to know what you're fighting for. Beneath that is a black star, and the Ghanaian flag has a black star in the middle. This is a symbol of unity. I believe very much so in people kind of coming together to help people. Beneath that, crocodile. Crocodile represents adaptability. So a crocodile can breathe in water and also on land. So in life, you might plan on doing something a certain way or getting to a certain point in a certain fashion. Things very rarely
never
go like you, you know what I'm saying? Like
right.
You plan, so it's very important to be able to adapt.
Kofi still alive. Remember, both feet have to hit the floor. Look at this! Are you kidding me? He saved himself!
There are swords that are crossed over. Basically, they symbolize courage and valor, which are obviously two important traits to have in life. The Siamese crocodiles, which is actually one of my favorite ones. It represents like democracy, right? So you have these two crocodiles with two heads and one stomach. So everything that you do affects somebody else, you know? So just conscientiousness, you know? What looks like a bunch of lines and stuff, it's a cloth, which symbolizes learning, constant learning. There's actually another thing that looks like a knot. It's a wisdom knot, and just, you know, wisdom in general. It's important not only to be smart, but just to be wise, to be patient, you know? Finally, on the very bottom is like, it represents an eagle's talon, which is strength. You're always learning. You want your mind to be stronger. You want your mentalities to be stronger, you know? All the tattoos and kind of the combination of what they all mean together is just that, you know? Always be trying to get better no matter what. Every single day getting better.
Kofi Kingston continues to amaze!
And then the wings! We're always told that we can't do things, and you have to go out and really believe that you can do the impossible.
Guys, I just said he can't fly, but I believe he can!
Wings kind of symbolize that, you know what I'm saying? Just to be able to be a man and, you know, and fly and look down at everybody and say, look, I told you I could do it. And now they look at you, oh, maybe I can do that too.
You probably come closer to flying than most people. Yeah. So at least you're on the right track. So
yeah, man.
I want to say thanks for hanging out.
Yeah, man.
And hey, what do you say we try to find some quarters?
I know.
We got change.
Do we need quarters for this? These might
be free.
They might be free. I think that's the big appeal of this room and coming to this building.
Because we know wrestlers love free stuff.
That's right.
Come on.
They sure do.
All right, Kofi. Appreciate it.
All right, man. Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Next week on Superstar Inc., I have the honor of talking with Roman Reigns about the tattoo that means so much to his Samoan heritage.
So anybody that sees me with this, they know I really like it that this is menacing. This thing looks dangerous to me.
Until then, head over to WWE Network to join me on all my Culture Shock adventures, available on demand.